And our gang started things off with Leather Skin Phones for that one reason. That's on Mercury Records. That's the theme song of this year's show, which is called The Clothesline. This is Andy Kirby Princeton. My name is Wobo, and I am the captain hat wearer on this show. So, more of a cue. No, I'll do something. Take care of a couple things.
Evan, it come your way then, and
fun to talk to Mark Melanson. We've also talked today to John Heyman, Faye Vinson, and I'm assuming most or all of these you can find, if you missed them, on WFAN.com.
Yeah, momentarily we should be joined by Mets catcher John Buck, which will be interesting. Talk a little bit about the development of Zach Wheeler. Certainly a nice performance by Zach last night, taking a no-hitter into the seventh. You'd like to see him at least leave the game with a lead. He left the game tied, but, you know, the Mets win it in 10 innings and find a way to scratch across a run. But Wheeler, you know, his continued development. I talked to Buck during the course of spring training, swinging, and he's very, very good, very astute, you know, talking about not only the pitchers, but also some of the prospects like Darnell and stuff like that.
Yeah. When these guys are going to, you know, Harvey's already, I don't want to say finished product, but you know how dominant he can be at the big level, obviously. You know, Wheeler's going to start growing into that. And it's fun to watch them learn and develop. And, you know, they're going to lose sometimes. You know, you got to watch them. If you want them to be successful, you got to let them give up the game-winning hit every once in a while so they can get to that point in the game and get over that and learn from that. And, he said you wanted to see Wheeler leave that game to lead and win for his performance, but in the end, he's going to get better and learn from it. It was already a good performance, but you're going to get better and learn from it.
Yeah, let's get the thoughts of John Buck. Mets catcher joins us now. Hey, John, Mark Melusa, Sweeney Murdy, thanks for a couple minutes this afternoon on the Fan.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
You got it, John, and let's start there. I mean, we were talking about Zach's performance last night, taking a no-hitter into the seventh inning. I'd like to see him, I think at one point in time, I think it was after the second hit of the inning, you gave him a gesture with your catcher's mitt to kind of maybe settle down or something. I don't know exactly, maybe it was something with his delivery, but what about Zach's performance overall last night, John?
I think it was awesome. I've been preaching to him, just pound the zone, be aggressive, get those hitters, knowing that he's going to come right after him. And he did, obviously, exactly that. Going into the seventh, I looked up there, I see he had like 10 balls. And later after talking with him, going over the game, he said, he was not so much watching the no hits in the column, but how many balls he had, how many balls he didn't have. I guess you should rephrase that, but he was very conscious of that. And that was his plan, to attack those hitters, and he executed it perfectly. And he got the results that, I was hoping and praying for. And got to see when he pounds his own like that, how effective he can be.
John, in a season like this, how exciting is it for you to watch, guys like Harvey and Wheeler? And I mean, we know how good Harvey already is. I was just saying, Wheeler is just coming up and trying to get a feel for this. How exciting is it for you to be a part of that?
I mean, that's a pretty special, unique spot to be able to be, kind of an older catcher with some experience, to be able to kind of be a big part of their development. It's like what I said when I first signed here, I'm excited for this, what's actually going on right now. And it's so fun to tell Wheeler, look, you have to do this, do this, and then he executes it, and then he gives you feedback after the game of, they started looking at that, and all of a sudden, I don't have to be as final with it. It's like, see? And so it's kind of a cool thing when they're trying to help develop pitchers who could be very, very special, and then to see it click when you, give them some food for thought and they take to it. It's kind of cool to see that all kind of fruition.
Talking to Mets catcher John Buck, you guys feel a kinship since you were both traded for Carlos Beltran at one point in your career?
We haven't talked about that, but now that you brought to that attention, maybe I'll bring it up and make that closer. I don't know.
John, what about is there any way to compare the two? I know we are much, not as far along in the development. Harvey was the starter for the National League in the All-Star game and has been exceptional all season long. But, you've caught both. What about any comparison between the two?
Personally, I like to just stay away from it. That way that he's not going to be Harvey. He's not, even if he does do it, he's not going to be Harvey. If they're young and they can both miss over the plate and get hitters to miss out, that's as close as I want to get to compare him as far as development or what have you, because I think it's unfair to Wheeler to say you got to be starting an all-star game next year, because that's very abnormal, and I think we lose track of actually how great Zach is developing and how well he's doing right now for the A's and service time and the time that he has even in pro ball. You throw him anywhere else in the world, on any other team, they're going to be like, this kid's ahead of schedule. The fact that he has Matt Harvey in front of him, I think that gives him some unfair comparisons.